This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we will explain the gravitational potential energy of a system. Solve an example on gravitational potential energy.
Before moving to the potential energy, let's discuss the effect of work on energy. When a force performs work, energy is transformed from a form into another, or and energy is transferred from a body to another. Let me give you an example. The yellow bus stops under the action of the resistor friction. And the question is, where does the kinetic energy of the bus go? The answer, the resistive friction force performs work, and this work results in a transformation of the kinetic energy into thermal energy. Now, let me give you another example. The player kicks the ball, and the question is, where does the kinetic energy of the ball come from? The answer, the muscular force exerted by the player performs work, and this work results in a transfer of energy from the player to the ball. So this is really the relation between work and energy. Now let's move to the potential energy. Potential energy is the energy stored in a system due to the interaction between its constituents. Now this definition may seem strange, but it will be clear when I explain the gravitational potential energy. Watch this video. This apple is released from rest and gains kinetic energy. A question, where does this kinetic energy come from? And the answer is, while it's descending, the work done by the weight of the apple results in a transformation of a stored energy into kinetic energy. Now, this energy is called the gravitational potential energy. Finally, each conservative force is associated with a type of potential energy. So the gravitational potential energy is called so because it is stored in the system object Earth due to the gravitational interaction between the object and the Earth.
Focus, please. This is important.
Suppression of the gravitational potential energy. Consider a system or an object of center of mass G. Now, before calculating the gravitational potential energy of the system object Earth, we have to take a reference level for gravitational potential energy. This reference level could be the surface of the Earth, or the surface of a table, or the ceiling, or any horizontal plane. So, the gravitational potential energy of the system object Earth is given by mgzg. M is the mass of the system, g is the gravitational acceleration in the place of the object, zg or h is the altitude of the center of mass relative to the reference level. So as g moves up, then z of g increases. So the value of the gravitational potential energy increases. Similarly, as g moves down, then z decreases, so the value of the gravitational potential energy decreases. GPE is an algebraic value. It could be either positive, negative, or zero. Depends on the position of the center of mass. If the center of mass is above the reference level as shown in the indicated figure, then GPE is greater than zero. While if G below the reference level, then GPE is negative. Now, when the center of mass of the object moves from an altitude ZA to another altitude ZB, so the gravitational potential energy varies. And this variation is given by GPEB, which is the gravitational potential energy at the position B, minus the gravitational potential energy at the position A. So delta GPE equal mg into ZB minus ZA by taking mg as a common factor. But we know that the work done by the weight at the object or as the center of mass of the object moves from an altitude ZA to another altitude ZB, is given by mg into za minus zb. By comparing the last two equations, mg equal mg and zb minus za equal minus za minus zb. So we conclude that the variation in the gravitational potential energy equal minus the work done by the weight. What does this formula or equation mean? The work done by the weight always or results in the variation in the gravitational potential energy. If the work done by the weight is positive, so the gravitational potential energy decreases and vice versa.
Now let's solve an application about the gravitational potential energy. Consider this figure. A uniform rod of mass m equal to kilogram and length AB equal 0.6 meter makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. Now, take a look at the given. The mass of the rod is 2 kilogram, its length AB is 0.6 meter. The angle between the rod and the horizontal is 30 degrees and the gravity is 10 meter per second squared. The first question. Determine the gravitational potential energy of the system rod R by taking the reference level for a gravitational potential energy as the horizontal plane containing point A on the ground. Look at the figure. So the reference level is the horizontal plane containing point A. Now to calculate the gravitational potential energy of a system, you use the formula GPE equal mgz. But what is Z? Now the altitude of the center of mass of the rod relative to the reference level is ZG. Now we must calculate ZG. Consider the right triangle AGD. In this triangle, sine 30 equal opposite, which is ZG, over hypotenuse, which is AG. So ZG would be AG sine 30. Now ZG equal. What is AG? AG is AB over 2 because the center of mass of the rod is at its midpoint. Now AB is 0.6 divided by 2. This is going to be 0.3. And sine 30 is 0.5, and then the answer is 0.15 meter. Now we are ready to calculate the gravitational potential energy. MgZg, the mass is 2 kilogram, it is expressed already in SI, the gravity is 10 meter per second squared, and Zg is 0.15, so the answer is 3 joule.
Part B. Now, the reference level is the horizontal plane passing through the center of mass of the rod. Observe the figure. We notice that G belongs to the reference level, so its altitude is zero. Using the formula GPE equal mgz of G, therefore, the gravitational potential energy of the rod R relative to this reference level is zero. Part C. The reference level is a horizontal plane passing through the point B. The figure shows that G below the reference level. So Z of G in this case is negative and GPE also negative. Use the triangle BB'G. Sine 30 equal opposite over hypotenuse. So sine 30 equal absolute value of Z of G over BG. So Z of G equal minus GB sine 30 minus, since Z of G is negative, then equal minus AB over 2, since the rod is uniform, so G is the midpoint of AB, then BG equal AB over 2, so Z of G equal minus 0.3, which is AB over 2, sine 30 equals 0.5, therefore Z of G equal minus 0.15. Going back to the formula, GP equal mg Z of G, 2 equal m, 10 equal g, and minus 0.15 equal Z of G, therefore GPE equal minus 3 joules relative to this reference level.
Now, question number 2. The rod is rotated counterclockwise until it becomes vertical. Consider the figure. So this is the initial position of the rod and this is the final position of the rod. So it is rotated in the counterclockwise sense. Deduce the variation in the gravitational potential energy of the system rod Earth. As you know, the variation in GPE is given by this formula. Delta GPE is equal to GPE final minus GPE initial. This is going to be MgZg final minus MgZg initial. Now let's take Mg as a common factor. So delta GPE is equal to Mg into Zg final minus Zg initial. Now examine the figure. Where is Zg final minus Zg initial? Now here is the initial position of G and here is the final position of G. Now, where is the difference in altitudes on the figure? It is H. Now, we want to calculate H. H is equal to AG, which is AB over 2, as you know, minus AG sine 30. Now, AG sine 30 is the initial position of a G, which is already calculated in part 1. Now, substitute H into the formula gives delta GPE is equal to MG into AG minus AG sine 30. Let's take AG as a common factor. So this is going to be delta GPE equal MG AG into 1 minus sine 30. Now let's go to the numerical application. The mass is 2 kilogram. It is already expressed in SI. And the gravitational acceleration is 10. AG is AB over 2. It is 0.3. And sine 30 is 0.5. Now the answer would be 3 joule. Now take into account that while calculating the variation in GPE, you don't have to know where is the reference level, because in calculating the variation in GPE, you need to calculate the difference in altitudes. In this figure, the difference in altitudes is H, and as you see, the calculation of H is the same wherever the position of the reference level.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.